We know that the effects of using phones a lot, the addictive effect, the effect on children's mental health and well-being, it is not good if they use it too much. And so all we as parents have to do is we have to add this to the list of all the other things that we have to parent and police, like smoking, drinking, drugs, eating well, exercising. It goes into that list, and it's just another one for all of us who are already struggling enough as parents to have to go, we need to keep a real eye on this, and we need to have some boundaries and rules in place and try to adhere to that.
Liz, I just wonder if this is the future. This is just what life's going to be like, because I know so many adults, myself included, I always use the excuse that one of my alarms is on my mobile phone, so it has to be by my bed. But your mobile phone is constantly in your hand. I use it for work, I use it for social, I use it for alarm clocks, I use it to shop. And kids are just doing exactly the same thing. They're just being a bit more tech savvy at an earlier age. They'll have an advantage.
Well, they need to be able to use it. Clearly, they do, actually. I mean, my oldest is 22, and my youngest is 2. So there's been quite a spread across the years of my children growing up. And certainly my older children grew up, apart from my son, who's 16, in a world without smartphones and without constant access. And honestly and truly, I think they were maybe a little happier, and I think they were calmer, and I think they were more focused. But they do now, children. My 2-year-old knows how to use a phone. She knows how to scroll, and she knows how to, and she will need to do that. But Sarah, you are a professional. Your phone is your workplace, and so is mine, and so is the case for many, many people. A 5-year-old child, that's just not the case at all. The beside the bed thing is actually one of the most important, I think, for me. If it's for an alarm, get them an alarm clock. You can't switch off properly if you know your phone's there. And you know what children are like. They won't switch the volume off. They'll be checking for their notifications all the time. Ask teachers. Children are turning up absolutely exhausted to school because they're not sleeping. They're checking stuff in the middle of the night. They can't concentrate. It's genuinely very bad for them. And as I said at the beginning, if you equate it with something like smoking or drinking, you wouldn't just say, oh, well, I drink of an evening. Oh, well, I've had the odd cigarette, so it's okay for them. You try to prevent these problems and stuff which is damaging for your children, and we have to add it to the list. It's so boring, it's so exhausting, it's so annoying. Also, we're supposed to lead by example, and none of us do, but it's the job of parenting to try as much as we can to go, I have to have some boundaries in place. I'm as guilty as the next person. You know, I definitely let it slide and let it slip from time to time.
I go back to this is the future, this is a resource we've never had before. We never had it as kids. I mean, I wonder how we'd be reacting now if we'd have had it from such a young age. I mean, is this not just the way it's going to be? Children are using mobile devices in schools now for learning and things like that. I just wonder if we're putting up a losing battle here.
Well, they are using devices, but I always speak against mobile phones in schools. So iPads, yes, and computers, yes, but I'm a real no mobile phones at school person, and I stick with that for all of these reasons, because a phone is a computer, but they're not using it only as a computer, they're using it as a communication device. It means, and if you think about what you're doing, like, so, you know, here's my phone, right? My child has this phone. Everybody in the world can be on here. Every single person in the world who's connected to the internet can come what, into your child's bedroom. You think that's okay. Not you, but, you know, that we might think that's okay. The line that this is the future and, you know, that they're just growing up with it, that's not a very strong line, because if it was a different kind of poison or a different kind of thing that was bad for them, we wouldn't just say, oh, well, they've always grown up with, you know, being hit by a truck. It's not okay, and we have to get our heads around that and work out how can we get the benefits from it, how can they learn the important stuff, and how can we protect them from the stuff that's not okay. If there was another addictive stimulant, you would take that away from your child. A mobile phone is basically
okay. Liz Fraser, you've probably got a very good point there. No fizzy sweets before bed, certainly no mobile phones. Liz Fraser, a parenting expert there on children and mobile phones.